Hello and welcome to the next module in the Abuse and Coping Mechanisms course. This module is called What Does Abuse Look Like? In it, we'll talk about how you can tell if someone is being abused, and then we'll look at why abusers hurt other people. But first, let's talk about some of the important words we'll be using in this module. Sexual. Intimate physical contact, like sex. Genital. To do with sex organs. Withdrawn. Not wanting to talk to other people. Deprived. Not having enough of basic things. Psychological. To do with the mind. Because most abusers and victims of abuse don't identify themselves as such, it's important for people around them to recognize the signs like changes in behavior, depression, fear, or unwillingness to make eye contact. Physical abuse is the easiest type of abuse to recognize because it leaves the most obvious marks. Some of the clear signs of physical abuse include unexplained falls and injuries, wounds and bruises at different stages of healing, broken or knocked in teeth, scrapes which can be from ropes or being dragged, bruises in strange places like inside the arms, on the neck and thighs, injuries on the head or face, very passive behavior. Physically abused people can be quiet and fearful and don't look people in the eyes when they are speaking. Abusers who hurt other people often do it because they feel that it's a way to have power over their victims. They may have seen their fathers physically abuse their mothers and never learned other ways to control their anger or frustration. Sexually abused people can show different signs and behaviors from those with physical abuse. They might walk or sit with difficulty because of injuries to their genital area. They may also begin acting very sexual or talking about sex a lot. On the other hand, they may become very withdrawn and nervous around other people, particularly men. Sexually abused people often feel worthless or that their only value is sexual. Men who sexually abuse women might believe that it's their right to have sex, or they might hate women because they have been rejected by them. Husbands who sexually abuse or rape their wives may think that it is their wife's duty to have sex whenever they want it. It's important to remember that it is still abuse if a person is called names, shouted at, made to feel stupid, or threatened with punishment. The scars from emotional or psychological abuse can be much deeper than those from physical abuse and can take a long time to heal. Psychologically abused people are often afraid or have a difficult time talking to others. They feel sad or depressed and can struggle to find a reason to take care of themselves or others. They might seem confused or agitated. Emotionally abused people often eat too much or too little or have trouble sleeping. All of the happiness is taken from their lives and they often blame themselves for upsetting their abusers or making them treat them so badly. People who emotionally abuse others are looking to control their victims. Because they don't hit or physically hurt them, they might not realize that what they are doing is wrong. But threatening people, calling them names, or making them feel worthless or stupid can hurt people just as badly as hitting. Now that we know what abuse looks like, it's important to better understand why people abuse others. Abusers often do what they experience growing up. Violence is a learned behavior. People who grow up seeing abuse are more likely to become abusers or be abused. People who hurt their partners want to feel in control. They want to feel powerful and strong. They usually don't feel good about themselves. It could be that they don't feel secure about work or money or other parts of their life. Abusers think that if they can control other people, then they will be powerful. Often abusers understand the terror of being the helpless victim, and so they choose the opposite, that is to abuse, rather than simply opting out of abuse altogether. Abusers are often also afraid. They are scared that their partner will leave them. They think that this possibility gives their partner power. In order to stay in control, the abuser will hurt or threaten the partner so that they are too afraid to leave. Many abusers believe that they have the right to abuse. Throughout history, women have seldom been considered equal to men. Instead, men thought of women as some kind of property they could own. In many cultures around the world, men used to beat their wives to show that they were in control. We now know how wrong this is and have laws that protect women from this kind of behavior. The Bill of Rights in South Africa's constitution says that all men and women are equal. No man is allowed to control his wife by hitting her or threatening her. Abusive people often also blame their victims by saying things like, "I just wanted her to listen to me," or "It's her fault, she made me do it." Some abusers think that they lose control and cannot stop themselves from hurting the people they love. But this is not true. People can control themselves and choose how to behave. They can choose to hit other people, or they can decide to deal with their problems in other ways, like walking away until they have calmed down or talking about it. Abuse is a serious problem, but it's not one that can't be solved. Both victims of abuse and abusers can break the cycles of violence and abuse, and friends and family members can help them by supporting them and offering to guide them to professionals who can offer real solutions. In the next module, we'll dig deeper into ways victims of abuse and abusers can get help. But that's all for now. We hope you enjoyed this module. Until next time, goodbye, tot ziens, sala kahle. You can now test how much you can remember by answering the assessment questions.